How's it going, lads? Marshall here, and welcome back to another video on the channel. This is the series The Best. Now, this is The Best Strikers as of right now. This could branch out into The Best Wingers, The Best Defenders, The Best Goalkeepers, but it is The Best Series. Now, I'm not literally calling it The Best Series, but it is The Best Series. But lads, if you do enjoy, you know what to do. The support in the last episode, oh my good gods, so good. So if you can replicate that on today's video, lads, I might just cry. But lads, if you do enjoy, a like would be appreciated. Subscribe to the channel if you are brand new around here. I want to sell like targets. I never do this. I want to sell like target. 1,000 likes because we have Icon 94 rated R9 in today's episode. That would be absolutely sensational. Subscribe and turn that notification bell on and let's get into the episode. So we've got Zaha, we've got Ronaldo. Last time out, we had Ben Yedder, we had Lukaku. Now, they are the current top 10, as you see right now. But at the end of the video, we're including everyone. We're jamming them all together. Everyone I've reviewed so far, including Ben Yedder, including Lukaku, and including like the likes of Mbappe, Cristiano Ronaldo. You know what I'm saying? We're including absolutely everyone. And that was the feedback I got from last episode. So as you can see, in the squad, we've got Zaha. We've got R9, Ronaldo, the Brazilian, the original Ronaldo. And yeah, lads, I'm looking forward to this one. I really, really am. And the buff on 10 chemistry in-game, they'll switch with Cruyff. Cruyff and Zaha will switch. They'll both be a striker, both on the instruction of getting behind, stay forward on them. No kind of differential that could affect their goal output or anything like that. As for R9, lads, 5-star combo, 5-star skills, 5-star weak foot, medium and low work rates. That's always turned me off with R9, you know what I'm saying? You look at that and you think he's not going to move too much, but honestly, this card is absolutely exquisite. You look at his in-game stats, you think, where can I fault this card? Aggression, it doesn't matter. It does not matter. He's got 89 strength. Aggression doesn't matter in the slightest. Stamina, 79. Will that matter? Lads, his work rate's medium or low. It does not matter. He's got great pace, 94 acceleration, 93 sprint speed. I've stuck an engine on him as well. The shooting category is stacked to the max. The passing is good enough as it is, and the dribbling was sensational. As for the traits, he's got finesse shots, and that is it. Outside of foot shot would have been good with the card, but he's got a 5-star weak foot. Anyways, as we move on, we have a look at Wilfred Zaha, which is not quite on the level as R9, but I want to include in this series an expensive option and a cheap option. I want to kind of alternate between the two and give you the best of all worlds, and maybe even at the end of the video, we'll kind of change them. Now, the main thing you see there is a 3-star weak foot for Wilfred Zaha, and stat-wise, maybe the headering? I mean, he's jumping 60. His height, what was his height, by the way, lads? I can't remember his height. I think it's 5'11". That's not that bad in terms of height, but jumping, that could be definitely an issue. Shooting looks okay, especially with a finisher chem style. Plus 15, taking 95 finishing. The shot power is good. Long shots, not the greatest. Volley's not the greatest. The pace is there. The dribbling is definitely there with this card, including 92 dribbling and great agility. The strength isn't actually that bad with this card either. Doesn't have any shooting traits. He's only got the flair for the contextual touches and the fancy passes and whatnot, but I was really excited to use this squad and it didn't let me down either, lads. Zaha and R9. Zaha and R9. 5-star skill extraordinaires. We're going to get into the gameplay right now, but like I did say, if there's any advice or anything you want to pass on from this series, drop it in the comment section below. Anyone you want me to try out, drop it in the comment section below. And if you've made it this far in the video, like it. I don't know, lads. Like the video. I've set a like target today, 1,000 likes. If we can hit that, I'll bring this out more often, lads. But let's get into the gameplay. So here we go, on into the gameplay. And see the records on screen. Ronaldo on the left, Zaha on the right. Now, in terms of the outputs, they're both got the exact same. 6 goal contributions over the course of the 3 games I did play with each card, and in the same team as well. Look at Ronaldo, man. He's a skill and extraordinaire, especially with those 5-star skills, but Zaha is also the same. Now, just remember, lads, this is a showcase. It's not a head-to-head. I'm literally comparing these against every striker I've ever used in FIFA 20 World Ultimate Team. I'm not comparing them against each other because Ronaldo would win every single day of the week, but it just goes to show, even the cheap players can have the same outputs as some of the best players on the game. This is R9, 94 rated, mid-icon card. You can see that cheeky smile on the left-hand side of your screen. But Zaha, he had the same output, 6 goal contributions. I mean, 3 goals. He wasn't really that involved in the final thirds, especially in the early stages of the early games. He was getting assists and whatnot, but he wasn't really doing this kind of thing. What a turn from Ronaldo, and what a finish with the 5-star weak foot. Something that Zaha does not have. He's got a 3-star weak foot, and that limits Zaha massively. It does limit Zaha massively, because you look at a 3-star weak foot, you think, apart from the chips, he's not really going to score too many times, especially on the freestyle weak foot. Now, inside the area, freestyle weak foots don't matter too much, but outside the area, they definitely do matter. You see Zaha's pass in to R9, and R9 does finish it with aplomb into the back of the net. Lovely finish there by R9, and that's something R9 gives you as well. He doesn't miss chances. You got to get used to his power on the shots. You got to get used to his finishing abilities, and you got to put the right amount of power on the shots, but he generally doesn't miss chances, giving him the opportunity. A nice little pass back there to Rudhullet through to Zaha. Look at this first touch, by the way. Oh, it's exquisite. Exquisite second touch as well. Inside the area. What was I saying about left-footed chips? It does not matter. They are still accurate on this game. 2-star, 3-star, 4-star, 5-star, 1-star. Weak foot, it will go on target. It should go on target anyways. Because chips are... what's the word for it? They're more gravitated to the center of goal than any other shots on this game. There, I didn't even know he passed me the ball, and Zaha passes it on R9, and R9 puts it in the back of the net. So when it comes to goals, R9 is possibly the master on this game. He just finishes in every single sense of the words. Outside the area, inside the area, on the volley, on the chip, on the finesse, you name it, this guy can score it. So left foot, right foot, he's got a 5-star. Weak foot, man, he's got 5-star. It does not matter, and his positioning is key. Absolute key. Gets a chance here, passes it back, not too selfish there, and Zaha does tap in to the back of the net. Great run by Zaha on that run as well. But movement-wise, online, it's not that good. Positioning-wise, sensational. It is so good. You will absolutely love it. Nice little finish there from Zaha. Reiterating his finishing ability, because I know it's like 80 or something like that, but if you add a finisher camp style, plus 15 to 95, you can definitely score goals in this game, can Wilfried Zaha. I see R9 on the ball, nice little drag back. He plays it through towards Wilfried Zaha, doesn't quite come off with the pass, and my opponent does go on the attack, but we'll bounce back, and we will get another opportunity. Yeah, he played so well for me, lads. He really did play so well for me. Did Zaha for his price. It's not that bad. It's not that bad. Now, price-wise, you look at, like, Rashford's and stuff or the Premier League strikers. Zaha, he's very versatile. You can play him striker, you can play him cam, you can play him centre-forward, right-wing, left-wing, left-forward, right-forward. Lads, he could play in a multitude of different positions and different roles within your team. And he actually won me a penalty here as well. Can't see how wide to Talisca. Look at him. He's keeping on side at all times. Gets a chance. I try to chip the keeper, but... I don't believe that should have been a pen, to be honest. Edison did foul me. I love that smiley face tattoo on Edison's neck. I don't know what that represents. It's just nice. I don't know what to say about that. But yeah, Zaha will get the chance because he won the penalty. He might as well take it as well. Now, normally, I curse myself when I do this because I normally take it with the player that wins the penalty and I miss. But Zaha does finish with aplomb despite these really bad penalties. Penalties are just 50-50. It doesn't matter about the stats. Basically... the lower the penalties, the bigger the reticle. The higher the penalties, the lower the reticle. So, lads, with that being said, let's get in to the top 10. So, here we go then, lads. Now, this is a number board. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I can count so well. Those are the numbers. Now, that is the top 10 right now. I'm going to increase that in the future, the top 20, top 100s. Potentially the top 100 on the game. And these are the strikers right now. Last episode, we had Ben Yedder. We had Romelu Lukaku. And number 1 and 2, I thought Ben Yedder was better than Lukaku. Lukaku was very limited on this game. He did offer a lot, but he's not even going to make the top 10 today because he is going to be replaced, is Romelu Lukaku. Ben Yedder does feature in the top 10, but because of Lukaku's... I don't know what to say about this. Lukaku's limitedness... or how he's limited, he doesn't feature. So, we'll wipe the board clean. We're back to the top 10. And now, everyone's going to come into play. Everyone I've reviewed on this game so far that I can remember, that I can literally remember. But, lads, are you ready? In 3, 2, 1... bang! This is the top 10 strikers in FIFA 20 Ultimate Team as of... I don't even know the date. The 9th of the 11th, I believe. It's the November, 9th of November at 124. Lads, this is the top 10 as of right now. As of me doing this video, in my personal opinion, I don't know if I've went through each and every single striker I've ever reviewed in Ultimate Team, but I will make a spreadsheet and I'll keep up to date with each and every single player I do review. Do review? Not sure I meant to say that. But look who takes the crown. It's the Icon Boys. R9 beats the original... well, Cristiano Ronaldo comes in number 2 ahead of the original... No, wait. We're starting that again. R9 beats Cristiano. Ronaldo beats Ronaldo. I reckon Cristiano Ronaldo is one of the best strikers in the Ultimate Team. Now, Mbappe comes in at number 3, but... Mbappe is a better all-round player than Cristiano Ronaldo. I just believe in a striker role, Cristiano Ronaldo is better than Mbappe. It's just my personal beliefs. Mbappe is more versatile. He's a better player in general. It's just Ronaldo is a better striker in general. It's very hard to explain my personal thoughts, but those are my personal thoughts. Rashford comes in at number four. He's one of the most broken cards this game, periods. Rashford is so good this year. Coming in at number five is a recent review. It's actually Antoine Griezmann. I thought Antoine Griezmann's left foot was golden. Everything he touched inside the area turned to goals. And his touch and his passing, his dribbling was absolutely fantastic. Ben Yedder comes in at number six. I was going to say number five there. Ben Yedder, number one last week. He's number six this week as we include everyone. Ben Yedder's one of those crack cards. Five-star week for the four-star schools. It's just one of those cards that's it's constantly going to feature. Whichever version of Ben Yedder's always going to feature because he is that good. Dries Mertens comes in at number seven with Fernando Torres at number eight. Alex Teixeira comes in at number nine. Now, we've got Wilfried Zaha at number 10 ahead of Romelu Lukaku, but that's just for the video. I couldn't have just one page with, like, Lukaku sat there, Zaha sat there. They'll be all lonely, lads. But we'll enhance that next week. So for now, for video purposes, Zaha is in the top 10. But if it wasn't for the video, and I wasn't featuring Zaha today, he wouldn't even be in the top 10. Zaha's very good in this game. He offers you a lot. But at the same time, freestyle week, but limits him a lot. And did that rhyme? Or did I just say the exact same words? But lads, this is the top 10 as of right now on this channel. I hope you have enjoyed the episode, man. I set you a like target today, boys. 1,000 likes. If we can hit that, like I said, I might just cry. I'm not going to record it. I might just have a tear in my eyes. Well, tear in each eye. Well, those are literally eyes. But lads, I hope you have enjoyed in general. This is the top 10. I love doing this series. I hope you guys enjoy watching this series. I'm going to enhance this series. I'm going to expand the series. We're going to keep doing these, and if you want them more regularly, 1,000 likes, I'll get this next one out in 2 days, 3 days, 4 days, 5 days. Lads, we'll get it out much more regularly if you hit the like targets. But thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a great rest of your day wherever you are in the world. Like, comment, subscribe, and I will catch you all next time.